took a pill in Ibiza to show Avicii I was cool.
Alright, what's up guys? So I wanna try and make another video to help people who are still confused with the game. So when you go into a maiden's chambers, you come in here and you just click random visit. Pay visit is just for if you want to work on one specific maiden and you want to get her specific EXP up if you're like a big pay-to-pay player. But 99% of the time you just pick random visit because it really doesn't matter. And they give you a lot of like stuff, free stuff, like these blue potions. I had about 100 of them and I used 30. Or I've used a bunch of them throughout the time I've been playing, but I used 30 today. And just to get a random visit with a maiden, just to get a child. And like I said, look, there's these items they give you. These right here, these don't really use them. I wouldn't recommend it. Unless you have a military, some maiden that pairs with military, which I don't believe I have any of them. But these you can use on whatever one you want. Like, it doesn't really matter, and it helps you speed up your questing. And just use all of your items. Like, look, this is gold. I got 5 million gold from that. 100,000 soldiers, 100,000 green. This gives you goodwill, which you use to go on possessions. If you have the time to just spam the button, this is what I would do. I've done it like twice already, and I might do it later on. But you click on the leprechaun thing right here with the plus sign. You set it all the way down to zero because to increase your luck to find the maiden, you need to use gold or gems or whatever, and that you could use it, but it doesn't really matter in my opinion. It's just faster to go on a random procession, and I let my luck go all the way down to zero since it doesn't really matter, because they give you like random really low stuff and the chance to even find the maiden is really low to begin with. So it would be nice to find one, but like I said, it's not necessary. Since you're doing this for Tapjoy, you don't need to worry about it since you're gonna reach level 8 or level 9 and then stop playing anyways. So that's more for the long term, and you don't really need that. As you level up, they're gonna give you more maidens for your heroes. Like, at 7 days you get Helen, and then they just give you, as you level up in power, they also give you some maidens. I don't think I have it anymore, or I might. But there's like a little thing right here. I don't think I have it anymore, but there's a thing right there that's like, oh, once you reach 1 million power, they give you some maidens as well from there. I forget the rank, but they give you some maidens. I don't know what this is. I don't have a clue what this is. So this is the first time I'm seeing this event. I don't even understand. I have 3 plays available. I have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing. So tap on this. Alright, I get it now. Who already blew his shot? I get along with old timers because my name's a reminder of a pop song people forgot. And I can't keep a girl, no. Because as soon as the sun comes up,
I cut them all loose and work's my excuse. But the truth is I can't open up. And you don't wanna be high like me. Never really know why like me. You don't ever wanna step off that roller coaster and be all alone. And you don't wanna ride the bus like this. Never know who to trust like this. You don't wanna be stuck up on that stage singing. Stuck up on that stage singing. Oh, I know.
Alright, I'll do some more later. But that seems kind of interesting. And we're ranked 147. Which they do give some pretty good rewards just for playing. Finally stop lagging out. Alright, so here's something that I want to show you guys. It's a limited time quest. You click on it and you go into it, and they basically it tells you what to do. Like, you get a login daily quest that gives you some pretty decent stuff, and then there's like do random, like it tells you what to do, like pay random visits. If you do it a certain number of times, you get an equal, like a reward equating to the number of times. There's a raise children one today. It changes every couple of days. Like right now it's going from the 2nd to the 5th. Increase kingdom power. That's like your power. I think you can find it in your boss thing, and it tells you how much you have. When you increase your heroes, it also goes up. When you increase your maiden bond, it goes up. When you increase your child bonds, it goes up. Yeah, you just find, when you kill alliance boss, I think alliance are available starting at level 7, so a lot of people aren't gonna be able to do that. We're gonna probably see a cut right here. Sorry about that, but whenever I record and play this game at the same time, it lags out. So increase kingdom power. As you can see, you click on it and it takes you to how much you've increased. These rewards are really nice, but it's really hard to increase that much kingdom power unless you're like pay to play. I don't know like any special tips for it, but this one, upgrade your maiden skills. That's why you wanna pay random visits. And just use as much of that as you can. Like, you can buy more baby space if you want to have a chance at a child, but to be honest, it doesn't matter. Like, one or two, especially in the beginning, right now where we are. I've had a 3-star child that had like some decent potential, but all you really get when they marry is like a little potion for babies and maybe a little bit of gold, so it's not really that important. But the bond skill is important, so if you can use your points to increase the bond skills, especially for like the gold right here, and then they have the blossom for the maiden event right now, that's what's more important. Like, I went all the way up to 100 in total children maze just to get all of these blossoms and the shovels. And right here you can see I'm gonna finish this off or do as much as I can, because I want the soldiers so I can go into the expedition. Man, I tried to do this, but increasing, that's kind of irrelevant. And I am holding a feast. So if you guys want to join my feast, I'll show you my password. Alright, so I think it's worth it because we get a shovel for that. Alright, so right here in the bottom, you can see where it says feast information. No one is attending your feast yet. My player ID is right here, 147000376. So when you come over here, you can attend the feast. Please enter your friend's ID. So just put my ID right there and you can attend my feast, and you get points for attending the feast, which you can exchange them. And I think some of the better stuff to get, it's random refresh stuff. But there is a king, oh, I forgot what it's called, but it's over here. I'll show it to you guys. It's over here as well, and this is where I got my first one. Point exchange, and it's right here. Console coin, those are pretty rare to get, and they're probably very important. And you can also get Alliance Charter, which gives you points for your guild, which you can use to exchange for stuff. So that's where I would go for it. And the reason why I wanted to do that is to get that shovel, and I'll probably go for a few more since I really want some shovels, because this event gives, this one right here has a chance to give you Excalibur and the Holy Grails. Right there, you see a Holy Grail, which both of those items give you a chance at, oh man, so we got the Excalibur, and then we got gold, and then we have this. So that's mainly the reason why I wanted to do it. And we can get more go on possession. I'm probably gonna do that, and that's one of the things I want to do is host council, but I haven't figured out how to do that yet. So once I figure out how to host the council, I'll probably tell you guys online. Council, castle, tournament grounds, king's council, host council. You don't want to ride the bus like this, never know who to trust like this. You don't want to be stuck up on that stage, stuck up on that stage. All right, there you go. So that's how you do it. All right, so if you guys want to join this, I'm not too sure how you guys would join it, but it's 3 hours. You could probably check in the broadcast or something. But there you go. So that's how you host the council. And my guild ranking is rank 6, so that's pretty nice. And we should have gotten an award for it. Should have gotten a reward, but didn't yet. Alright, so hopefully we get 8 million. Now I think we got 880,000. Alright, so I think that's a lot of the stuff. Basically, check your bag and use any item. Use all your items in there that you can, except like the intimacy stuff. Unless you have a maiden that's attached to a military general. And you can check that by clicking on the maiden chambers. You click over here. You click on maidens. And then you click on any of the maidens that you have. Once it loads up, I'll click on one. Anyone. And then you go upgrade skills, and then it'll show you the hero that she's attached to. And then you might, unless you memorized all of the heroes already, you might have to go look at him. Cause I can't really tell like any of this stuff just by looking at him. He's really good with money, I can tell that, but that's basically all I can tell from that. So that's basically it. You wanna upgrade? I have no military maiden. So just basically click on as much stuff as you can. Do your possessions. Oh, a shovel. That's what I was. Host the council. Yes. Alright. I literally forgot why I even did the council meeting just for the shovel. So there we go. We get a holy grail. We get gold. Another council. So we basically made up for our council already. And I did all of this free to play. We got an advancement. So that's a lot of XP for mercenary contract. That's amazing. And we got a poison for. Yeah, this is all good stuff. Maiden jewelry box, famed hero token. And we got a feast invitation. So we got all of these today free to play just by doing all of the events that are available today. So let's go into this and use. Oh man, we got shafted on that. Hopefully we don't get shafted on that one. And we got shafted on it. 8,000 plus one plus five. Also, don't use this one. I just used it and I didn't read it, and I just noticed that increased intimacy, so you don't want to use that one. Anything that increases intimacy, you don't want to use. But look, I have 5 Excalibur and 7 Grails. I don't think the Grail is open right now, because usually it's a cup thing. And I don't see it there right now, but you need 10 Excaliburs to pick one of these heroes, and they're all really good. I think I'm probably going to go with Arthur, King Arthur. Or Beowulf, those are badass. Yeah, and don't forget to check the ranking daily. To pay homage right there in the bottom. You get 20 gems just for paying homage to your. To your players. And I think that's it. So I'm gonna end the video off here. I'm gonna have to edit it and I have to go to work. So I'll try to upload it if I can right now. And if I can't, then I'll try to upload it tonight. Hopefully it does help people. The dungeon is right here. just click on it, click on one tap, like there it says one tap punish, and it does it way faster than if you just manually punish each one. And check your quest log right there in the bottom. As soon as you finish stuff, just follow this feather thing right here, just do what it says, and just go into the campaign mode and just keep campaigning as much as you can until it says medium risk to lose. Because on medium risk to lose, you are gonna probably lose, and it'll cost you time to restock up your soldiers. So that's why I only do low risk. So yeah, I'm gonna end